Hey, Jordan Bench here, jordanbench.com, and this video is all about Bible verse memorization and renewing your mind. Now, if you are someone who is recently saved, or maybe even saved for just a little bit of time, and you have a really big goal of you want to start memorizing Bible verses, before you start doing that, I want to ask you a question. What is the reason of why you want to memorize Bible verses? Like, what's the overall goal? What's your agenda for doing it? When I first got saved, one of my goals was to memorize Bible verses, because I saw other people that were able to like recall Bible verses just right off the top of their head. They were able to spit it out, and I was really impressed with that. But as I began to like learn how to memorize Bible verses and began to do it, I started noticing something, that my focus wasn't in the right direction. My focus was too much on just trying to memorize scripture, that I actually didn't necessarily understand it and become it, because that's really the key to this. It's not the fact that you just, you know, are able to quote scripture, but you're actually able to become it. Because when you read it, that Bible, it's a mirror to you. It's going to be a reflection of who you're supposed to be and how you walk this out, right? So that's really the whole goal and purpose of it. So for me, I went down a path to where I began like watching so many YouTube videos on how they memorize Bible verses. I took some different like memory courses from some of the top memory masters, because I wanted to figure out what do they do? How do they memorize stuff? How do they recall things? I downloaded several different Bible apps because I really wanted to be able to recall verses. But like I said, my focus was not necessarily in the right area. So after kind of getting frustrated with trying to memorize some Bible verses, I kind of came to a discovery, and it was through a man named Curry Blake. I was going through one of his trainings. I think the training was called SWAT training. And as I was going through this training, he was talking about how a lot of times when people try to memorize Bible verses, they have a hard time. And sometimes they begin to struggle with it. So I was able to memorize Bible verses, but I was struggling with it. And he said one of the reasons why people struggle with memorizing Bible verses is because technically the Holy Spirit did not add chapter and verse to the scripture. That was man who added that, which is very much true. So when we read the Bible, we have to understand that a lot of times we're reading books or reading actual letters that people wrote. And sometimes when we just try to memorize and focus on one little scripture, we miss the entire context of how it was written and who it was written to and the whole purpose of it. So sometimes it's better to actually understand the context of a passage versus trying to understand or trying to memorize just one little verse that we can just kind of throw out of context sometimes and make it fit our own situations. So really what I'm saying is, instead of trying to memorize one Bible verse at a time, just spend time reading through like an actual book, like go through one of the books, go through one of the letters, and spend time just understanding that. And as you do that, that word gets in you. Now, I'm not saying we shouldn't memorize Bible verses. Like in the New Testament, like I said, it doesn't say that we are supposed to memorize Bible verses, but it can still be a good thing to at least know where things are at. Like, I think it's good to know where a certain section of scripture's at, like what book it was in, maybe what chapter it was in. I think all that is really good just to have an idea of where you need to go. But ultimately, the more time you spend in the Word, the more time you spend like reading through certain passages and going through the letters, it begins to get in you. And as it gets in you, it begins to come out of you, which is really the key. So it's not so much about just trying to memorize scripture, because I've seen a lot of people who memorize scripture and they're extremely religious and they really take things out of context and they use it against you, or they use it for their own purpose. And that's really not at all what we want. We don't want to be somebody like that. We want to be able to have scripture in us to where it comes out of us. So hopefully right now I'm making sense and I'm not like turning you off to the idea of actually memorizing scripture. There is a way that I do it, which I think is really beneficial. A lot of times what people do when they try to memorize scripture is they do what's called rote memory, to where they just repeat the same thing over and over and over. And sometimes that can be good, and sometimes that can be kind of monotonous and not necessarily work the best. There are other methods. Like there's certain apps you can use, which I'm going to make a video on that and talk about some of the apps I actually do use. And when it comes to like mind renewal and memorizing Bible verses, there's a thing that's really key to doing this. So like what I'll do is, if I'm reading a certain section of scripture, what I'll do is I'll emphasize each word at different times. So let's just say I'm reading one verse. As I read that one verse, I'll emphasize the very first word with extra enforcement behind it. So, for instance, if it says something like, I am a new creation in Christ, if it's something like that, I'll focus on the word, the first word, I am a new creation, right? You just go, and then the next word, am, I am a new, right? So you just kind of take each word, and every time you repeat that, you just emphasize a different word. And what happens is, as you emphasize each different word, that verse gets a slightly different meaning to you. And as you say it so many different times over, it begins to get in you. Now, that right there is not mind renewal, to when you're just able to, you know, repeat scripture and repeat scripture, and then it's there. That's not mind renewal. Mind renewal is actually where you actually get that scripture in you. You say it over, or you speak it out loud, or you listen to it. Sometimes you can record your voice, or maybe it's somebody else's voice, but you listen to it, it gets in you, you speak it, whatever it is, but then you begin to act and do upon what it says. So if you're saying something about what God says who you are, or about what you're supposed to do, but yet you're not doing those things and you're not acting like it, I'm sorry, but your mind has not been renewed to that specific area. So the fact is getting that scripture in you, and then also letting it come out of you, but you walking in that. That's part of mind renewal. That's really what it is. Your mind is renewed to the degree in which the thing that you're able to walk in. So that's really what this comes down to. Like I said, I don't get hung up on really trying to memorize so many different scriptures. Like, yes, the scriptures are in me. I know they're in me. If I hear a scripture, a lot of times I can finish it because I know it. But a lot of times I can't recall the exact verse or the exact chapter and where it's at. And I'm actually okay with that, because I'd rather have the scripture be in me and me able to walk in it than me be able to quote 200 scriptures but yet not know them personally. So hopefully I'm making sense, and hopefully this is kind of giving you an idea of where we should be going and everything else. Because the idea of just memorizing scripture to memorize scripture to maybe make yourself look good is not really the point. The point is to get the word in us and for us to walk it out, because we've been equipped by the Holy Spirit, and he helps us recall these verses and the books and the letters. He helps us recall the stuff, but we have to put it in us first for it to be recalled. So, like I said, one thing I would do is go through a certain book or a certain letter, and as you do it, go through the whole thing. Read the whole thing in context, but read it slowly. Spend time with it. Don't just try to rush through it to read the whole book or to read the whole letter. Just spend time, go slowly through it. And then as you read it, maybe focus on a verse and emphasize each word as you go through it. Like, really spend time to where you're really hitting and emphasizing the word, or maybe you say each word slightly different to where it gives a different meaning to you and it becomes more alive and more real to you. And I think if you can do that and really step in that, you're going to start to see your mind get renewed, because you're going to start acting and exercising what you've been learning. Now, this is a big part of what we call mind renewal. It's a big part of getting rid of the carnal mindset and actually stepping into who Jesus has called us to be. So hopefully we don't get so focused on actually trying to memorize verse after verse after verse just to prove points or whatever, but we actually try to get the word in us. So I hope you got some value out of this. If you did, please give this video a like, give it a thumbs up. Also, please comment below if you have any questions, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Hit that little bell so you get notified when I put a new video out, and I will see you in the next video.